digital circuits will give you two stable states. So you only have two stable states. And this could be either on or off. On could is represented by 1 and off is represented by 0. So if I go on that switch and that would be my part, since I am not scared that anything could happen to me, I can only either switch off, there is nothing. So if light was to be a value 1 and darkness was value 0, so now I would be on state 0 and the other state is, so state that is 1 which is on and the other one is off. But we can also use high and use, in the lab you will be using 5 volts and then you will be having the ground representing the off side. And if you got the diode, if you got a simple diode, in the lab it is nicer because I get a diode and plant it here. But I get a diode and I'm able to make it lie on top of this place. And then you get a resistor. And this is your ground, and you can achieve this ground using one wire from the ground of the breadboard circuit, and you put it within the breadboard. The breadboard has these conduits, these many ones are conduits in this direction, whereas you have the other ones which go in this direction, the blue and red. These ones are all white. The neighboring ones in this side, so here is this continuity, whereas along here there is continuity. So whenever you want to tie two wires, you just use any of these cords. So this can, I can use this experiment, not experiment, but this illustration to simply be able to demonstrate the high and low, whereby if I put here a LED, I don't know whether this looks like a LED, it may look more or less like a gate, which will not be a good idea. So if I put here a LED to give me either a high or low value, that is bright or no light, then I can have the two states of either 5 volts here for 1 or ground in here for 0. So this is what happens. If I connect this ground in here and I have the 5 volts here, this 5 volts is able to come and flow in the forward direction of the diode, since the diode conducts in only one direction. Come this way and the circuit is complete. And okay, disappears into the ground. Whereas this other LED here, which we have, it will remain off because this voltage here won't bother itself to go this side where you are going to first make the holes go away from the electron. The electrons go away from the holes and then cause the brightness in terms of radiant energy, and then hence the light we normally see. So that's why when you have ground, you can indicate it by seeing nothing. Okay? So on the other note, if instead I connect this other side to the 5 volts, the 5 volts will go and reach here and they say you cannot pass. Okay? So if they say you cannot pass, then this one also tries to come and flow to this other direction and finds this fellow. Tries for it, can go up to this side, up to here, where there is a roadblock.
at the junction
and finds this one which is saying, we are here, we don't have anywhere to go, we can't allow you to go anywhere. So eventually these five will be forced to go this other side. So it means when I put in 5 volts, I get one, I get that one to light. I ground this one, and then I get? So that's how we can interpret the simple analogy of these belts. We can push this a little bit further and get a couple of other states in what we call the gates. So if I had an arrangement of, or if I made an arrangement of the two diodes, but before the arrangement of these two diodes to go further, the parts of the logic gates can be easily demonstrated using what we call switch analogy and the diode analogy. So let me first start with the switch analogy. Those of you who have done this experiment in the lab have always tried to go through it. So assuming we presented these any two signals, any two inputs, this A, B are called, these are inputs. You can call these inputs as commands. For example, if your dad tells you it's okay, you can go to dance, and then the mom is saying when you go to dance, you may end up being pregnant there. There are two inputs. Then you have to process it. You have to say, but that what does that know about pregnancy? Maybe mommy is right. Your processing, it is up to you how you process these inputs, okay? So these are simply two inputs, but we can represent them using switches. So I have a bar, I have the bulb for indication, and then I have switches A and switch, and I can represent this in what we call a truth table. I'm a truth person. If you lie to me, you are in trouble. So in the future, or even as we are doing this course, never lie to me. Like you meet me and you say, you know, I have a problem, I'm supposed to go home, ABC. Don't lie to me. Because you may end up like your colleague who lied to friends that are going home, and the next thing she was being a superwoman from the third floor. No matter how sad it was, but it is not good to lie, because the consequences may not be the best. So there are for these two inputs, there are four possibilities. And these four is when you have both of the switches switched off, switch A off, switch B on, switch A on, switch B off, both switches on. So let's see, if I have this switch off, this switch off, what happens to my bulb? No light, because it has nowhere else. If I switch on B, if A open, what happens to my bulb? No light. If I switch on A, leave B off, what happens to my bulb? So it is only when that switch A and switch B on, that I'm able to get, that's when I can complete the circuit. And that's when we get the signal there. So of all the four options, it is only when the two switches are on, that is A and B, which we write as AB, that I'm able to get a signal. And that's why we use this. We find this being an and gate. That's it. When they tell you draw a truth table, like in the tests, normally I would ask, or you'd be asked that, draw the symbols of gates and draw their truth tables. So you draw the symbol and then the truth table. Common sense. You just, if you have the speech analogy in the head, you shouldn't have any problem. And after this section, I'm sure some of you will always try to want to forge the experiment D2 and do this algebra in your heads and put there without touching the. So from actually Wednesday, I'll be always keen on D1 and D2, especially D2, seeing whether things are aligned. Because I know most of you will be tempted actually go ahead and start producing them theoretically. Because now you know how it happens. So we draw an AND gate with a semicircle and represent the two inputs, A and B, and then the output Y is equal to A and
B.
So this is the circuit symbol of an AND gate, and then this is the truth table of AND gate. On the other hand, if I was to put these two switches in parallel, switch A, switch B, and I get the buzzer, and I put the ball, I can draw the truth table, the states are still simply, we have two inputs A, and then we have the occurrences of switch A off, switch B off, switch A off, switch B on, switch A on, switch B off, both switches on. And then we shall be able to see how that happens. So if I have A and B off, I wouldn't be able to get a current flowing through. So I will get the bulb very dark. So it will be off. If I leave switch A off and I switch B on, what happens? There is an alternative where the B is on and I will be able to get. If I switch A on, leave B off, what happens to my bulb? The current has an alternative through A and I will still have my switch on. And if I switch both on, the current will divide here, go through them, add its own fear according to Kirchhoff's law, and complete the circuit, and I will get the light. So it's either when A is on, or B is on, or both are on, that I will get my bulb light. So this one becomes an on gate. Either A or B or both, and we write that the way we write universal sets in mathematics by using an addition sign. In some books, you find some people using A or and we draw it using a fish head. Fishes are like this. Is it fishes or fish?
Fish.
So D1, this is how you come up with. Well, you know, the reason now why I will no longer leave you alone is because I want to be sure that when you are using the chip, you tell me which leg was A, which leg was B. Because when we go to the maps, within your, and before I forget, experiment 10, make sure you got the love when you have growth. So if you had, this is leg 1 up to leg 7, and this leg 7 should be in the ground, and this leg 14 should be at VS. So if you have, for example, for the and, you have your leg 1, sorry, 1, 2, 3, and your and get would be like this. You have this leg here, this leg here, this is your output. So this is your A. This is your, okay, this is your A, this is your B, this would be the Y. So, but another one, may decide to use 8, 9, and 10. And instead uses, this person may use the this other gate, yeah? Whereby, whereby their A was 8, their B was 9, and their Y was 10. So it is not a master that you have to use this, their own gets there. And remember, those I've been telling in the lab is that in order for this chip to work, you must make sure that you ground it, you must make sure that you give it 5 volts from the breadboard setup. That's when you are able to have this function. And I normally use the example, since each group has a lady, it's an example like of a family. For your wife to act as a wife, you must make sure that you leave her money every time. I know most of you will finish and you work. Will you also take your husband's money every morning? Huh? Well, you have to marry her officially, you use her, pay her. Okay, take some gifts to their parents and build her a home in order for her to offer you the wife thing. So that's the same thing. You must make sure that you grab this, you power it, that's when you are able to use this, the disease appear. If I get another example, I will change so that the ladies don't have to be groomed when I'm using the example. I mean, I'm sorry to always use you as an example. It's not gender bias. I'm trying to. You see, men are very dumb. You know, they are, after all, they say we are dogs. We don't have much, do you? So that's why I use that motherly thing. The mother has no outcome. So if there are no comments from this, let me talk about the diet. We can also use diets. This, you can't have switches in there and switches and bulbs and you insert an area, can you? I uploaded the yesterday's lecture and that one of Tuesday. I combined them to have the feedback, and then I put the link about feedback from Wikipedia and another link for operation amplifiers from Wikipedia. And for feedback, it covers a lot of stuff, whether it is in education or psychology or any feedback. From politics, they cover, Wikipedia always covers. It's not that much an official academic thing, but it gives information and it is more or less authentic because it's an open platform. Anyone who is knowledgeable can do the editing. So if they post something which is fake, a person with commanding the content can be able to edit and say this is not. So Wikipedia is always something that basically on general knowledge,
give you some general idea that make you understand.
That two diodes, D1 and D2, and I have a resistor there. I think it is about 100 ohms in the lab. So I have this ground in here. Then I have the how that is. I think I'm better off wrong this thing. Like a diode should be. Okay? Let me put it CMOS. So if I have 5 volts here, this is our ground. So if I put, in the first place, this 5 will be always willing to go through any of this part. This is our indicator. So if I put the first one, where we had, we want to draw a truth table with our A, then B, I will leave this one open, we shall judge it later. So 0, 0 will be ground. Ground, 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 5, 5, ground, 5, 5. Okay? So if I put ground here, if I ground here and ground there, it means that I have given a good alternative path for this 5 to flow comfortably, and nothing will bother itself to start causing the dissociation of electrons and formation of holes so that we get light in the lead part here. Okay? So we will end up with our lead being dark. It won't light. Now, if I ground A, but give B 5 volts, it means the 5 will come and hang in here and oppose any 5 that would have passed here, but the 5 from this side will flow to the ground. So nothing will go this side. The other round is when I put the A on 5 and then ground B. I will have the 5 hanging in here, pushing away the 5 to this other side, which will be comfortable to go through, and nothing will ever bother to go to the left. So I'll get. Then the last bit is when I put both of them on 5. So I get the 5, 5, and all of them are saying nothing will ever pass here. So the 5 that comes from here will eventually come. And then we get a 1. We get the light. So this one is which gate? The AND. It is only when A and B are enhanced with the 5, that this 5 will never pass and come here and be able to go through. So this is the truth table of AND gate. So when you look at AND gate in this chip here, it means that they got those diodes, chopped them, after chopping them, they made them in a combination and pushed them inside here. So for this AND gate in your chip or your integrated circuit, it means that the 5 volts which we feed here is this outstanding 5 volts you are seeing at this point. That's why you need to power it in order to give you the properties of the gates. The other is when we get these two diodes, make them face the other direction, and then apply our 5 volts from our breadboard. So I have these diodes now facing this direction. I have input A, input B, then I have the 100 ohms, and then I have the ground. But I can try to put this and that, and then anywhere here, I can now try to put the LED, the light emitting diode. So if I have this at 5 volts, this is our ground, which is our zero. First round, so I draw the truth table with our A, B, and then whatever comes here, we shall discover it later. When we ground A and ground B, ground A, and then put 5 on B, put 5 on A, and ground B, and then we put 5. What first round? Round. We don't have anything in the circuit. There's no current here. There's no 5 volts anywhere. Nothing would happen here. So I will get a zero. But if I get the other round is when I ground A and put 5 at B, it means 5 would be able to flow. There's nothing which will take place here. 5 will flow here. It can't come up here. 100 is more huge than the recombination effort, so it won't find it easy to pass here than going there. But it is always put there to make sure that this does not blow up. That's why we have this resistance. The resistance reduces on the PD so that the diode has a share. There is a shared PD so that it will not make it blow. So that's why if you go to the lab, do not get the lead and you try to put on 5 and ground directly to test whether it works. It will light once and disappear. And you will work to make it light and it will never light again. So do not do that mistake. That's why in some of the boxes you find that the other leg has resistor to solder on it to protect it. So that was round one. Round two, I will have this 5 going through diode D and I will get light. The other round is when I ground B and then give 5 to A. A will have 5 going through. This is grounded, fine, but it can't be able to grow this way. It will be stopped here. So it can only be able to flow here and there. And this is also a bit laborious. Just like I told you, if your dad is very tough, you normally go to the dad and start going to the mommy and say, "Mommy, you know, they said we buy a textbook. There's that guy who always teaches electronics, he says we buy a textbook. How much? It is 50K. You come here and give the money." But you know, when you go to dad, you say, "Which one? You first bring, I see the potential." So we have here also giving you a 1. The other one finally is when you have both A and B given 5, 5, the 5 will flow, and then you get. So this will be representative of an OR. It is when either A is grounded, is given 5, or B is given 5, or both are given 5. So here we write it as A, and the rest is that we said this is a semicircle with your A, with your B, giving you an output Y, which we present as AB. We said this is a fish head, which has two legs, so input A and B, output Y, which is AO. So after these two analogies, it should be easy for you at any one time that when you draw these things, even if you were away from internet, away from the textbook, you should be able to sit down, draw these gates, these diodes, or get those switches and come out with the truth table without any hassle. Hence, the reason why I normally tell you to record here on which leg. Is it leg 1 and 2 giving 3? Is it leg 8 and 9 giving 10? Is it leg 11 and 12 giving 13? So that I know that you actually did. But now I'm adding something more on Wednesday that I would also want to see how things are lighting up. Especially for D2, I will be there, I will be peeping to see, or I will come and say randomly, just do for me this algebra, the Boolean algebra of this one, and I see how it works. I apologize for those who have already done this section of D1 and D2. That's how life is, but I'm sure now you realize how they, because I've always been doing this. And when you go to the D1, you are able to use a mirror. When you use the mirror, I guess, is it a voltmeter or an ammeter? I guess it is a voltmeter. When you are having less than 0.6 volts, is it 0.6 or 0.7? Then you can comfortably consider this to be a zero. And if you have 3 volts and above, you can consider this to be the 1. And then you'll be able to draw your truth table, even if you are using it. Then you can go ahead and put the circuit on the breadboard and be able to use the indicators in the form of the legs. When they light, you know they are lit. But you can invert what we call inversion, like the inverting operation amplifier. There is a note. The note is that you expect, we would expect any joint where we have this triangle to be continuous. There wouldn't be any problem. But if we put a dot like that, it means that if this was an input A, the output Y would be an A prime, would be a wave at the top, can be a wave at the bottom, would be a bar at the bottom, would be a bar at the top. Depending on the nomenclature which is used in any of any either textbook or in the person who is teaching a particular course would be able to be comfortable. I'm sure in the book, are we using this in the manual? The prime for not. And the truth table is simple. You have A and your Y is A prime. So if you have 0, this is 1. If you have 1, this is, that's it. So if we put a dot on an AND, then we call it a NAND. So this would be equal to A, B, bar. This is A. So we call this one a NAND, not AND. If we put a dot at this one here, we call it a NOT OR. So this would be Y equal to A or B NOT. So this is A, this is B. So this would be a NOR, NOT OR. We shall get others, exclusive NOR, exclusive OR, exclusive blah blah. We shall get a bunch of other nomenclatures. So, you know, all in all, in the lab, I think experiment D1 will be using the nodes here, the nulls, sorry. So, don't be confused that why should I ground here, and then I'm able to get a light here. Because if it was an and, 0, 0 would give me 0. But then in the lab, you'll be able to get light. Simply because of our wife has a house, she can always know how to, even if you leave a little money, she can always cook nice food. And when you go to the, any one of you use, do you have any lift, functional lift at campus? Yes. Elevator. Yes. Where is that? Okay. In the new building of Senata, you can remember now there is a functional. Even I talked about it, and only that you were thinking of campaigning, so you never used to be attentive. On the course outline, if you are here, I remember talking about the elevator. You see, everyone comes, points in the movies. You are a person who watches movies, you see them waiting for it to open. And they are comfortable. It will not forget. They have given it the command. So it comes as they are going to level 4 and he stands. If it opens, they enter, they don't care whether the door, they don't have to say close. It knows that I'll open for him, and then he will enter, and then I'll close, take him to level 4, I will open, he goes out. I'll close, I'll go to the level where they are calling me, or go up. So there are some people who just go and enjoy the lift, they go up. For me, when I went there, it was not a good experience. And that's why even in Sedata I was not remembering, because I don't want to use the steps.
Because when we are going up, I feel like I'm so stuck on the floor.
And when I'm leaving the top floor and we are going down, I feel like I'm about to jump. So normally I start. Because if you remember in the mechanics, if the lift is going up, it means that even when you look at the fighter jets, or when you are about to lift off in a plane, that one I can confidently talk about. When they are going up, you feel like someone is pushing you on the seat, and then when they reach out there, you feel it is relaxed, and they say, now when you are going to land, and the guy, like, there is a way when he, you don't know where he touches, you feel like you are going to fly around, so that's why they say you. And it is worse if you are in a fighter jet. I've never been there. Probably I should go to another and concoct a story. So I'm teaching these kids. I want a ride, but you know, I think it is so expensive to give you just, even if they flew up and came back, it is a lot of money. You should be able to go past a million if you have to use it. And then the risk is high. Maybe you come back, you may have an issue. I wouldn't want to perish in a fighter jet when I'm not a fighter. So that is one of the appliances. But even your phones nowadays, for example, the way you, when you are setting, we shall see, like some of the FM radios where you have to reset and set. You are looking for channels and all of a sudden you press on the reset, it goes back to 87.5, Akabos. And then you wait until you scroll back to whichever other one you want to go to. Any other question before I guess button?
No, of course, this is the same way. So, what about triangle?
There's no triangle. It's a sword. You mean the sword? There is no triangular way. How do you go?
When it is not
but even the sawtooth is calling us. So that, where do you get the triangle?
Triangle is saying, it goes, it's when something down, it's not from him, it's very straight. It's not
slanted. It comes straight. That value is normally discontinuous. It's like, much as you see the that part, so the part which you see, it is zero, the, for example, for a square, for a square wave. This whole value is zero. If we were to look at it, we have zero and then it shoots up to a value one. For example, I'm just giving an example. You take a one to be a five or any other value. Ha. So it is zero all this, so it is low here, and then it becomes high for this long, and then it becomes zero again. Here you don't have anything happening. It's just so if the lights have been on, I flip them. Zero. They go off. Someone enters, switches them on, they go on, they become high. They read books, we attend lectures, and they, when I'm saying I'm going, and then you flip them. Then they remain zero in the night, in the morning, when the Pascalia comes. Those are. Any other question? I just wanted to spend this hour on this so that we sort out. Just like I told you, learning is a process. Good enough. I've used my time, which you stole. If there are no more others, enjoy your marathon.